This workshop today, it is the first of its kind in the faculty of art and culture. And I thank God that we're able to put up this, in spite of all the constraints we've passed through, to get to this point. And those who conceived this workshop have carefully selected topics that will help us put money in our world's pockets. And the team says, multiplying that in your domain. And they put it wide to bring in fish farming. Fish farming is an aspect of, is a part of aquaculture. And in that aspect, where we are going to is fish breeding, production and management, which is one aspect of fish businesses, functioning fish businesses. And what are we trying to achieve is to make sure there is a paradigm shift from importation of fingerlings from other parts of this country. My name is Dr. Patrick Ogbeni, as I'm introduced. By way of introduction, we have to look at what is fish farming. Ancient belief and modern time belief. Fish farming is the act of cultivating or rearing fish in a systematic way with the intention of harvesting them for man consumption and what other uses. They will talk about ancient belief concerning fish. Before now, or in the time in memorial, people believe that fish resources are inexhaustible or aquatic organisms are inexhaustible. But today we find out that it's not true. Okay? Ancient as time went on, they found out that it is not true that aquatic organisms are exhausted. There are reasons for that. And if they are exhausted, it means that they are supposed to be what? Replenished. And what gave credit to that belief is that they believe that because fish are caught in abundance, it is then inexhaustible. Then sheep is a sheep source of protein, contain vitamin minerals as we know. They are easily digestible, less connective tissues and less fatty acids. These are the qualities that make fish important to engage in the life of our people. But today there's a big one. In the annual fish, there's a thing like the annual fish pot caught on the wire. Why is there a decline in the annual fish pot? Because of one, destruction of habitat, destruction. Modernization these days, pollution of water bodies, the size of industrial plants, modernization, use of chemicals in farming like fertilizer and these bodies are washing to the water. And what do all these things do to the water? They not only go there and pollute the water, make the water environment unconducive for the fish to grow. Right. They kill those fish that are pregnant and those that are in their infancy, which we can no longer harvest in due time for human consumption. These are the reasons for depletion. And so the others, they will have the babies of nature, like flooding, erosion, siltation, because in some of our rivers today, whether that the sizes are becoming and shrinking as a result of siltation. You look at population fishing method, there are people who are still using dangerous chemicals, explosives, dynamite to do what? To fish. Then we have damming of rivers and the rest of them. Then another reason for depletion is increase in population. And this is where we are highly affected. And all these give effects to what we call the fish breeders. Now, before I go really into this topic, please help us to know. Because the impact point here is for us to do what? To know some areas, the ones of fish breeding or fish farming. People see it as being very narrow. There are a lot of job opportunities for anybody that has gone into fisheries. If you have studied fisheries, there are a lot of places you can work, you can begin as an entrepreneur, you can import, there's employee establishment. Then there can be a fishery consultant. Then the fish breeder, which is the main thing we are here to look at. We want you all to become fish breeders so that the paradigm shift you have might be successful. Then we have other reasons, can be a fish breeder. All these opportunities are multi-million spending businesses, which if you get to graduate and get into it on your own, develop the skill, you can go into them and make your living out of it and be an employer of them. So our impact point here is to be a fish breeder. Yes. So fish breeding, production and management, it is the main reason why we are here. To teach you how to know, breed fish and produce it. When you say you have to use, then to manage it. And why do we do that? We mentioned it earlier, said depletion of national stock, increase the population, lack of fish seed for cultivation, lack of functional fish to feed, lack of technical know-how. Yes, you must have enough fish fingerless supply for farmers to do what? Farm, isn't it? If you don't have them, you can't do that. So, and it's not all the fish we have in the ocean are fossorable. They are not all of them are fossorable. Then we have lack of technical know-how. Some of the fishes are not in research upon, we know how big they are what? They can be domesticated and know their biology, they enable us to know how they can work, breed. So there are some which we have as a due to research, you know, those that they can be domesticated, and there are qualities for fish that can be 10% what fish species. And for example, we have so many possible species that have been tried out and we know they are possible to be domesticated. For instance, in Nigeria, the most popular fish that we grow in our farms are catfish. That's the thing. Everybody knows that. Go to any big eatery, you see them having point and tail. What you see there is catfish. There are reasons for them going for catfish. Nigeria don't go where there is no profit. Not that other fish that we mentioned that are not possible, but we know. We want to minimize costs and maximize profits. So that's why we all are really happy. But practice is not a good thing. It has all the possible qualities. And nobody will jettison a good prospect, a venture and go for the one that is less profitable. Therefore, there are some of the possible features. Don't mind the way the scientific thing is written as one of those things that grabbing African world practice, which they say Clarence and Reclus, which is the most popular, not the catfish family, have the heterogrammus, the science are so many of the heterogrammus. One day in some area they call it Alela. Some politics, depending on the area you come from. Then we talk of the tilapias, and the Slavian Zilag, the Slavian Octopus, in Soteria, they call it the Ibas. All these have been proven possible fish species we have in Nigeria. In fact, in Nigeria, the two types of fish that we can do in polyculture, they are not the Slavian and the Zilag fishes. They have been. In the people they call it Ibas or some call it Obom. Then the Petrophys Nalitipus, people name is Popo, and the Natus Nalotipus, people name is Kedi. And we have the Natus Nalotipus is not Kedi, it is called Azuasa, and it is the secret of all the fish. Two of us, I'm not going to say what I'm going to say to that. Astra price more than any other founder in the market, isn't it? So, but we don't go with that certain So in fish production, there are three critical factors that must be there. And if they are not there, the person will not bring it. They are not there. You cannot compete with them. They are not there. Other people who produce and participate in the money out of business, they are one. Fish seed. And that is why we are here. Fish seed are the fingerprints. They work with water. If you don't have water in good quality and quantity, don't go into fish production because you lose at a loss. There is no one. The third one is fish feed. And this is a big industry. Fish is a very big problem with fish and farming. So, when one of these is not there, don't venture into fish. The three of them must be complete. So, you must have fish not only in quantity, but in fish, not only in quantity, but in quality, and in quality of water. Okay? Then, what are the qualities of a vegetable fish species? Which we say, quarters like cars and over other species. One, I say the ability to produce artificial. That is artificial population, which is what we are going to do today. We can be able to breed that fish easily, provided the right environment. But it's very difficult because there are critical stages. If you don't know how to tell how to have to go over that area, you will not succeed. Then we have, it must be fecund, ability to produce many offspring. Ability to produce many eggs. It is just being fecund. That's why one fish, one cat, and very catfish, or a pregnant female catfish, can give between 250,000 fingerlings to 500,000 fingerlings. So it's a modest, tiny world business. One, then ability to grow fast. If you have produced successfully within 3 months to 6 months, you have an average of 1 kg weight of one fish. Then we have ability to adapt to a wide range of what? Environment. Catfish have that ability. If you put catfish in a bag and put on there in most condition, you can take it to Lagos. And when you get there, just a little expressive pick up. But you cannot take any other fish that distance. Then, palatable. That fish is not too palatable, isn't it? That's why everybody is a choice fish. This is why you have the fish. Then, any cultural food fish must have ability to grow, to take artificial feed. Now you are in one cultural and you give it everything. This. Every country requires you are not to provide. So, you must have ability to eat what? Artificial feed. Then you must be resist resistant, and that fish has proven to be that. So, for you to begin to think of breeding, then what are some facilities you must put in place? The facility must have a hatchery. A hatchery, very important. In your hatchery, you must equip them. In the hatchery must contain a platform. It must contain the incubation plant. It must be properly reticulated. What I mean by reticulation means that there must be piping that will go through, have a flow through system where you have an inlet and a outlet. Then, so somebody, they must have your good stuff. Good stuff is mature, male and female. When I use gravy, you know that I'm talking about a pregnant word, fish. A mature male and a gravy word, female. Then you must have your hormones. Hormones are your complex, synthetic, systemic. Okay, you must have your, I think, systemic and non-systemic and natural hormones. Then you must have your plastic bow, your pistol, mortar, and so razor, proper knife, sharp, strong knife. You must have your physiological water, your hypodermic syringe. You must have a feather, and so many other dissolver, tissue, razor, and all weight balance. You must have your water testing kit, thermometer. All this will help you to, in the course of what? Do your breathing. So, there are steps in breathing. What we are doing here today is what people pay $15,000 and above to come and take. But this organization that comes together is putting up people out there for us to know if we can gain our ground in the area of fish farming. And it's thinking in this workshop. And I believe those who cannot go into it here can start a business out of this and employ people. There are steps. Step one is selection of what? Good stuff. What do you mean by selection of good stuff? For you to have a successful breeding, you must know how to get the good stuff. The good stuff that is the male and the female. You are advised to select good stuff that are not accepted at 1 kg. But in the absence of that, you can do with fish that are up to 500 grams or what? 800 grams. Fish that are not less than 1 year old. Fish to be sure that they are mature. For you to be what? Select them. And when acquiring your booster, you must go to a reputable what? Fish farm. It's true, you can go to the wild to get a good stock. But the pedigree or the history or record of their parents, they are not there. But if you go to a reputable fish farm where they are into good stock production, they will give you the pedigree of that particular one, fish. And that will help you to know that you are buying from the right source. And again, they will not give you diseased fish. So in the wild, you can mistake in bringing diseased fish. Therefore, now you get the damage process. Then, and after proclaiming selecting your good stock, how do you know which one is the female and the one is the male? That is the male. That's what we call sexual dimorphism in fishes. We call it sexual dimorphism, the difference between. There are certain signs that show that this one is a female and the other one is a female. So also in catfish, let's have a look. The catfishes, they look alike. But you know this, but for those who are into fish research, they will tell you this one is Clarus directinus. This one, Clarus lanzere. They will say this one is Petrobrancus longifilis. They will tell this is Petrobrancus apocontactus. They will tell this is they can differentiate due to some morphological issues. But you, as a layman, we are dealing today with that Clarus galactinus. Then, for the male, there are signs you see, you know, that this is not, for one, the male is always the head of the male, they don't know the head of the female. So, that's number one. Number two, the daughter team. Of a mature and ready to be used, which has is always small. And again, they have not got one of their problem. But for the significant signs, you have to call the better side of the world, the fish. go to the bank and look at it. The mail attendant has a long papilla that's pinkish at the tip. A long papilla at the tip. Another sign again is that you find that the mail is always what? Mail's cross sign. Cross sign that's showing that it is mature and can be used for prayer. Then for the female, what are the signs you can see? The visual sign you can see, number one is true. It has a distended stomach, swollen what? Stomach. I don't know. It has a distended what? Stomach. The first picture we saw shows the female that has a swollen stomach. Stomach is swollen from the upper column side to the what? To the genital side. It's swollen. Then, the female, for the female, I said, the first physical sign is this, that the stomach is swollen. Then the other signs include the turn the ventral side, what we call the ventral stomach side. We find that it doesn't have a long papilla. That clearly distinguishes the male from the female. It has a pinkish bulb. No, it has to be, but it's very short. So, once you see the two, that is the differentiate. And another sign is to make sure that you are quite short. A gentle pressure on the stomach will show some similar of what? Greenish edge. If you want to do it scientifically, you can use what we call the Kaluna. Kaluna is a kind of calibrated tube, plastic tube, which is inside through the nails. Go there, about 3 cm, push up the gun part. Just take it to be able to do what? To assess. The diameter of the air that you will know that this air is very mature for what? To be used for breeding. Having been able to select your good stuff, the next thing is to transport it to your what? Farm. Or to your hatch. On getting to your hatch, immediately separate the male from the what? Female. Put them in separate times. So, from there, you are ready to go into the what? Next stage. Which is procurement of what? Inducement of what? The fish. Why do we induce fish? We induce fish to enable us shorten the ovulation period of the what? Female fish. If in the natural environment, fish brood and begin to spawn around May to September and maybe to October. You see, it's a long period for them to about 4 months for ovulation to take what place. But inducing them with hormones shortens that to hours. Shortens that process to hours. Shortens that process to hours. Whereby now, the egg becomes ready to what? To spawn within a few hours, depending on the temperature of what? Of the environment. Now, how do you get the hormones? We say one is natural hormone, the other one is what? Synthetic what? Hormone. The natural hormone is got from the pituitary or the what? Fish that is situated in the skull of that particular fish. We don't discriminate the fish by using them by the name of the hormone or inducement. But we are always at our colleague that in the case a law that helps us a lot that the fish you are going to, the donor fish must be of the same weight with the receptor. They must be of the same weight. And it doesn't work in that it can equally be if you, for instance, if the receptor is 1 kg female fish and you don't see 1 kg male fish, you can combine 2 feet that have. If you add their weight, give it to 1 kg. It's allowed and it's successfully done. So don't put on one soap with one cage, you don't see one cage, because at times you can't get fish of the same weight at the same time. You can combine two fish that can donate to get the same weight that if you add their weight, gives you that of the same weight. Then another way, and how we say, because to get that mineral or food from the water, is called the fish. Then the synthetic hormones are those that have been produced by companies. For example, we have something that we have overprint, which many of us who have done printing. I know some of us must have tried printing one time or the other. You now use overprint, you have to overtype. The one we just did in we use overtype, and the other one we use the procedure. So it's a kind of comparison. All of them are fine. Then you can use one for the overprint, or the what is sorry, aseptic. We call it local for short. Grab the other one, but in Nigeria, in Nigeria, the commonest one we use is the overprint and the overtype. But at times, we tell our farmers, go for the natural hormone. Because some of these imported hormones, you don't know how long they have stayed in the warehouse, and the efficacy is not as sure. But for the particular get you extract from the fish, you are sure of that. But again, we must be very careful here, because if you don't know how the technical one, you might pick that flesh of the fish. For the what? Particularly, because it's very small. That's where you have the hands-on will help us to be able to know and get this thing correctly. Many people, when you pick the wrong one and inject, you think you are, once you inject the wrong part of the particular, you are missing it. Because there's no way the operation will take place, and there's no way whatever you describe will be hatched. So, the hands-on will now tell us how to get it. One thing you know that for you to get the petite from the fish, there are what we do is, first and foremost, get the male fish, the donor fish, blindfolding with a moist towel, burn it for some people just cover the head. Okay? That's how clean the male fish. In some people, we just use something to hit the head. These are practical animals which we are emphasizing these days. So we just cut the spinal cord by cutting between the front and the head and the back to mobilize the fish from acting. Once we're able to suppress the fish from acting, the fish is now at your disposal to use it. Then you turn it upside down. Turning the dozer back to the ground, you can wind the contrast side up. Then you now split the lower jaw to the point of the upper tongue. Then you open it, thereby exposing the what? The bomber bone. Then with sharp knife, because once you expose the bomber bone, scrape the flesh of the bomber bone to further expose the bomber where the situated. Then cut it down here and with the tip of your hand, remove that bone stitches. Then you see at the center of that, of the ventral side of the bone, what it is called, you see the petite, very small, very small and gland. Again, very small, very small. Then with a piece of it, you can now pick it up and transfer it to your words. So your plastic this mother is fine. Yeah, you must very careful not to lose it. Okay? If you are not going to use it immediately, you can store it in your alcohol solution. But you are going to use it today, you go spread. There are many ways of storing them before for this pleasure, but just know that once you are going to bring in extract and especially once you are starting to use it, then you do what we call You have to masticate it, brand it properly. Then that's where your zoological water comes. Take one mil or 2 mil of zoological water, add it there. Crack, continue to grind properly from who are to the close one to the centrifuge. Centrifuge that to make sure that at the point of that day, when at the end, there will be particles that will settle on the ground. And you will now collect what we call the supernatant. That solution at that point becomes a supernatant, that is the technology for that. Then you put your syringe. It has to take a minimum of 85 mil. Take 1 mil. Some people like didn't give 2 doses because that was in those days when breeding started. They give 0.5, 0.5 twice. You can imagine when you try to take you to give 1 dose of 1 mil. When you do 2 times, the only stress is the only stress was the fish. So today we do 1 dose. And immediately you get that, you go to the point of injection. This is the last breeding exercise we carried out. These are students injecting the female fish in the hatchery. And there are ways we enhance all the father tell us that. We inject at there are 3 types of injection in place of area of injection, the score, the pectoral, or the intramuscular. But what we did there is intramuscular, that's what you see here. So, essence of injection we say is to pass in the population and you inject between the dorsal fin and the lateral line. Pointing the needle towards the tail of the tail of what? Between the dorsal fin and what? The lateral line. For those who know where the lateral line is. Other than that, the tail they are injecting is not between the dorsal fin and the lateral line. Then, you gently remove the needle after injection and massage properly the point of injection. And this will equally spread the what? The hormone. And now, after having done that, you return the female fish back to the what? Tank. And cover with net, because at this time, you need to become breastless. And what we don't want to do to is to jump off the what? The container, and you do that by beginning to do what we call releasing the egg because of stress. So you cover with mosquito nets to prevent that. Then the incubation, guys, the latency period begins. What is the latency period? The latency period between the injection of the hormones to the time of what? Ovulation completes. And that's when we begin to spike. And this is governed by 2 main factors. 1 main factor, that is the temperature of what? Of the environment. The higher the temperature, the quicker the what? Ovulation. The completion of the latency period. And the lower the temperature, the longer the period of the latency period. So, having done this, for the upper print, like I said, it is the constant buy from the back 10 mil, 5 mil buy, or 10 mil buy. All you need to do is to get, use your screen, to take 1 mil and reject. Same way you do with that. I just explained for injecting the group tissue. Then you call it back, latency period continues, you can use the proper paperwork and all the things that you can. Then the next stage after latency period is what we call the word. Formation of the word, the male and female guidance. Because it takes two to work, can't you? In the male, milk is not there and the eggs are not there, there will not be fertilization. So you must get these 2 things to happen in place. And before you go into striping of protection of the male ingredients, you must have prepared your incubation port tank. Your incubation tank, like I said, for many people, they can use, there are 3 types of incubation tank. They work it. You can use the what we call the expanding type, the flow through or the circulatory port system. But I want to tell you that we know that in low occasions, that of supplements do fail. They do fail. But the one that is all over the place is the flow through method. And that's what we're dealing with. It's affordable, but the recyclable method has a lot of them. It's expensive, one, and two, the most sustainable and supply of electricity. For you to be able to achieve that. So what we do here, what we did here is to collect what? The male and female garment. For the male and female, for you to collect the male and female garment, for the male, you do what we call the sacrifice the male. Just like we did when we were preparing the petition. But in the of petition, the male of female can be used. But for the garment organization, the male below will be what? Used. Because the male houses the taxes where the males is domiciled. So what we do here is now the same method. Normally use the words and voice and forward help us to now tell the people how to treat them as the most grim and grim family because there's this phobia of catching fish. Some people even if you know that fish will not die, but once they read it or you have gone to what drop it, thinking that it's going to bite or hurt. No, catfish doesn't hurt. Except in extreme cases where they use their head, maybe then you do the most important organization of the get the justice. In the first place, the reason why the spelling of the speech on the meat and not popular or the meat is not on the gospel, the nation of the world is justice. The census is made up of the world to the vast of the world as well, in the world, world, four. So if you apply pressure, you can go through this, navigate this and to come out. And that's why we start, if you extract to additional points on the pressure of the stomach, you just allow the meat to come out easily. That's why we start to get this. So in this instance, what you do is to use a sharp pressure, a razor, always that, then to cut into bits the testes and then squeeze the milk inside the what? The head. Squeeze it inside the head and then use the feather, like I said, you have to get feather, which was sterilized. The part of the feather, which was sterilized, and oh, steer it. As you steer, the feather will squeeze. And the second day is the using of what? Male gamete and female gamete to form what? Zygotes. Which is very strong to them because the fish begins to what? Grow and hatch into another. So once you finish this and steer properly, for us in that, you say this stage is what we call the dry fertilization. For you to properly enhance the number of eggs that we fertilize, you can add the saline solution or the physiological water. What is the physiological water? So people begin to do saline water and they don't know the saline water is CF13 for the purpose you want to use it. For us, we prepare our own saline water. Saline water is a mixture of 0.9 gram of common salt to 1 liter of what? Water. The water was ready to boil and then allowed the water to cool. Then now mix it properly because of saline water and do that with because of physiological water. So this water that is what we now use to rinse the testes and make sure that every milk here is finding itself inside the water. The milk is a product of the fluid water, the sperm. So what work they want to do is the sperm of the fish that will not utilize it to form water inside the water. Having done this, things the third family must be through this. And we've got the next thing, which is incubation, because we said the next that one is same with incubation. Like I said before you go into this, you must have prepared your what incubation plan. In the incubation plan, you must have what we call the erector. Erector is that can help increase the oxygen level. The oxygen is very important in the incubation. Then you have the cacaban. Cacaban are frames that will wait on which to spread the what if it like air. The cacaban will be of any size, it can be improvised, can be, like what we have here, you go to the red, you find that it is made of frame. And now as we go over there, we have the one that we use the shreds of your jute bag, with the shreds, wash it thoroughly, disinfect it, and use a cylinder to wash it to use the advent of diseases. Then, you can use again, mosquito nets. Fold it very well, spread it inside the water. The important thing that the cacaban and not above the water, but the properly supplied. That's why we advise people to use airstone. Airstone has two purposes. It melts in the water, it helps to increase the oxygen level of the water, and we have to wet down the water, the cacaban, to keep it down below the water, keep the water level. Then we put it evenly spread. The fertilized head on top of the wall or the cacaban, evenly, avoiding, not allowing it to be cluster. And they have a reason of sticking to the cacaban once they are what? Spread. Then at this point, incubation begins. And at this level, it is very good and very hot. Careful in the sense that the temperature of the hatchery must be homogeneous. It must not be less than anything less than it. It's not shoot. If you start with, say, authenticate the degree by sentiment, maintain that position in the system. If not, most people have one society, but the people keep on trooping in and out. We must keep it under lock and key and allow the flow through system to do what? Continue. The flow through system has one purpose. When the water from the storage tank comes in, those who don't know the better, renew the presence of the incubator, increase the premium to the motor incubator, while the outlet will now remove waters that are dependent of oxygen and more of carbon dioxide will now go out. By so doing, the freshness of skin level in the incubator is what? Maintained. But if you keep on trooping in and out, frustrating the temperature of this might end up not succeeding in your breathing exercise. And that is where then again, if you delay in your fertilization, you might give room to what? Failure or reduction in the percentage of what? Success you will record. So, what you do now here is to maintain the ambient temperature. Then again, if the temperature is too low, in some hatchery, you are allowed to introduce what we call heat. That brings you a stove, a light, but then in one corner of the box, or the hatchery. Having done that, you allow the incubator, the fish to incubate. Incubator is being influenced by two factors, after the temperature, and then after a period of 24 hours, if your breeding is successful, you're supposed to begin to see larvae, fish, egg, ash, little larvae. But before then, for you to know and have an idea if you have succeeded, after 24 hours, you come to the incubator and open it. And you see a shiny, golden or brownish color, mass of color of eggs. You know that you have to begin to spawn because you are dismissed. But anything can happen if you become careless and begin to frustrate the temperature, like I said, stepping on speed to everything. But that means after 24 hours, you see this thing, you have to continue to do what you are doing. You need to continue to do what you are doing. As from 24 hours, to that hours, it is expected that all viable eggs must have what? Hatch into larvae. For some people, they say extend it to 72 hours. But the number is extended by allowing those sick wanted to hatch to hatch, might in one way introduce disease into the disease. So, between 24 hours and 36 hours, those are supposed to have must have hatched. They remove what you call the cadaver. Why do that? To make sure that you don't allow the follicles to fall inside the other one in the larva. That brings us to what? Third stage. Larva rearing. Larva rearing. This is the most delicate part. People, when they have succeeded in breeding, they think all has what? Assumed. The top areas. Forgetting that, at this point, we must be very careful in temperature fluctuation. Any mistake in temperature fluctuation at this point, you can miss, can lose up to 80% of the last level of fry. You can miss it. And if you continue within 1 hour, I'm telling you, you can miss everything. Come again, just wait for it. Like that. And the answer is where did all that go? It's like they just melted, they don't disappear. So at this point, it is very important that we maintain the temperature and allow it to work, acclimatize easily. Still maintain the flow through system. Why this project again is delicate? Because at this particular point, there are two types of feeding stages in the larva. We have one called endogenous feeding stage, and then of the exogenous of this stage. Once the larvae have their all rope sac carrying larvae, they have in the yolk contain nutrients that the fish feed for the first 3 days. You don't need to give them food at this particular point in time. Yeah, that's where the fish will begin to draw its nutrients for what? Survival. And they are called endogenous what? Stage of feeding. And after 3 days, the fish goes in, and the larva goes into what? The fat goes into what? The exogenous what? Feeding. By this time, they will now begin to move to look for their own food. When they are in exogenous point, they always go to the corner and hide. In that corner and hide. But one day, endogenous number one, they know it's all that is exogenous. So they have exogenous, which is what they want. So, endogenous, endogenous, when the fish feed from his blood side, then endogenous, when you begin to look at and this endogenous people, the fish have more ability to work for live feed or food. Live feed of single cell animals like the zooplanktons, the artemia, not pure artemia, which is what many people feed. But research has shown that human life in my research, my master's thesis research, I did a project on this, and we're able to find out that egg yolk mixed with a powdered yolk under pasteurized water can do very well in chicken production. And Professor Mumba, in her farm, the value farm, used it when she was in zoology to produce chicken. And the point is, I came for her to attend a session of my PhD program. And I saw her thing, I was eager for her to sign my paper and let me go away. I said, Prof, I'm spending so much time. But he said, it's not what you did in your master's degree that I'm applying here. I said, what? Well, the air drug and the other missing. But the only problem with that is that it's tedious. It pollutes water easily. You must be around 24 hours of work to make sure that you remove the non-eating food. Otherwise, you will pollute the water very fast. But it is. It was a successful design. She did it and she had a successful breakthrough. Otherwise, can you probably give some feed producing companies that are called branded commercial feeds that can feed our fries at that point? Age. That is betting. The problem is that the fish, whether branded, must present itself in three forms. One, must be what? Must be rich in good protein. Two, it must be palatable. Three, it must be water soluble. So these are the qualities of this life field, which is attractive to them. So once they begin their exogenous feeding, they look for those fortified, those zooplanktons, and they begin to feed on them. And the ability to do it is that once they move, they attract them and get them. So that's why we prefer Atemia, because Atemia can tell 80% protein. And that is what helps them to do what? Well, like I said, this is the kind of these are the incubation tank we used. This tank can only go for the red tank. After you finish your incubation, remove the cargo band. That's the frame inside here. We can now use it again for your red lab. Now, at the ranking stage, from 3 days to from 1 0 days to 3 days, that means it's not. Then from the end of the meeting, from that time to 14 days, you have to continue giving them your continue to give them the attention. After that, from 14 days, maybe to 3 days, you can introduce other fees, credit commercial fees. But this time, the kind of food they eat, the meat now is becoming more than the notifier and the attendant can give to them. That's why we have those in bracket commercial fees of different sizes. We have those that are of 0.025. 0.05, we have those that are 0.1 to all sizes, to 2.1. Those feet from 0.1 to 2 mm are called starter word feet. They are called starter word feet. And they are very important in the fish production. If you don't use them well, your fish will not grow. And again, after a successful breeding, you are expected to have four kinds of what? Set of what? Fish in every batch. One is what we call the growers or shooters. The growers and shooters are very good. And that's where the branding comes into effect. The value addition in fish production comes into it. And in the fish breeding business, we have chains of what? Value chain. Enter. Some people are interested in only breeding. And they come and buy. They don't want to rear anything. They look for those who buy them and try them. They sell them and do another breeding. Some people are interested in only coming to buy the fry. Produce the fingerling levels and do what? And sell them. They don't want to stop itself. So if you want to come and buy and produce the work, did you buy what? Yeah. And sell them and get another one. Are you getting it? And each of these levels, they are money making ventures. Then some people go into buying from the night, go into adult production. Then, when they get to adult production, they now go to the business side. Where they now sell it to you, to me. Some people go into come and buy process. They don't want to know how you go about it. They don't go and buy process and sell. Some package and export. Now, so the type of things you give them. So at the fingerling level, when your fish are at 10 fingerling level, it's now very attractive. It's simple. I say your fish is safe. At least I can use it for 1 month, 4 months. The second one is the medium. The jumpers are the ones that they put into Nigeria and call it Wonder of Holland. They call it the Wonder. These ones that are the shooters can give you 1 kg in 3 to 4 months. In 3 to 4 months, get an average of 1 kg. Then the middle ones, they are very good for production. We are looking at that for people. I want you, if you go to buy fish from anybody, or from anybody, tell me how old that, asking how old that fingerling is, asking how many people purchase from him, because you might be buying the middle one, thinking you are buying the what? You know, the shooters grow very fast. And they are separated in the middle. Because if you don't separate them, the beauty of the price and the price of it. The small ones. So if you do this, the second one is a million. That one can give you 1 kg between 4 months to 5 months. Still good for business. The one with one record is small. It's more than give you 1 kg between 6 months, 5 months and 6 months. The one is more, this is the last stage, which is the one called the bronze. The bronze are never doable and never doable. Even everything you can think of, they will remain content. So those ones we don't advise you to go into that. And that's also for the ones you get from the wife who give when you bring them to a questionable situation. Because you don't know the problem. So for so it is wrong to don't need all the other people to feed them back to the world. Shooters for them to eat and what? And grow. Okay. Having said that, fish propagation or proportion of African world fish typified by colours that we don't mind the it's always a wonderful experience. For those who have done it, you want to do it again and again and again and again. And if you're doing that one is coming, I don't think you can stop again. Then, due to continuous research improvement in fisheries technology, numerous methods and simple ways of fish propagation are available. You know this version I'm going to do, you might meet another person to give another version. Depending on what you see. For whichever you are that is available to use it. The important thing is to provide what fingerlings for our fish companies. So that the paradigm shift we are talking about will come and money. Artificial propaganda has shown that it has the only capacity to sustain agriculture and fish production, thereby help in providing cheap source of animal proteins. It is a very valuable source of stock improvement and restocking of our natural water bodies, which we know today. These days, governments carry out research and go and restock some of our water bodies with fish. First of all, they do what we call fish diversity of that water body. Know the kind of fish that are prevalent in that particular water body. Then they hash the fingerlings and go and introduce them to that water to help boost the population of the fish in that water body. Then, the value chain businesses in fish breeding are many and act as sort of job and income to many people, which are fine. People is explained. What only fish breeding is chain businesses that are embedded in fish breeding and minerals. The value chain. And finally, the return in fish breeding. It's fish breeding investment is very important. We pray that those who are capable of establishing fish pasture and employing people should do that. We want this institution who can help. I want to partner with the Department of Fisheries and Aquaculture, and as it will